Dear children, we will proceed ahead where we left yesterday. My childhood. We were doing the childhood story of Abdul Kalam, what he has written in his autobiography, Wings of Fire. Till paragraph 4, third, we have already completed in the previous video. Here I am going to start with the fourth one. Every child is born with some inherited characteristics into a specific socio-economic and emotional environment and trained in certain ways by figures of authority. Abdul Kalam ji is saying that every child inherit or take some qualities from their parents, and one's character, one's nature is affected with social, economic and emotional environment in which the authorities shaped him. I inherited honesty and self-discipline from my father. He is telling here that his father was very honest and self-disciplined, and he has inherited self-discipline and honesty from his father. From my mother, I inherited faith in goodness and deep kindness. Already it is told that in his family, every day his mother was making food for outsiders too, because she had generous and kind behavior. Here, this is what here reflected. He says, from my mother, I had inherited goodness and deep kindness. And so did my three brothers and sister. And he says, exactly the same thing was done by my three brothers he had, and sister, meaning they had also inherited certain traits from their parents. I had three close friends in my childhood. First he taught about his parents, now he is telling about his dear friends, his fast friends. They were three in number: Ramaradha Shastri, Arvindan and Shiv Prakashan. These were three friends, fast friends of Abdul Kalam. All these boys were from orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. Abdul Kalam was a Muslim boy, but his three good friends belonged to orthodox, meaning extreme, Hindu Brahmin families. As children, none of us ever felt any difference among ourselves because of our religious differences and upbringing. As children, though they belong to completely different society, still they never felt any sort of discrepancies. Ramanatha Shastri was a son of Pakhi Lakshman Shastri, the high priest of the Rameshwaram temple. Later he took over the priesthood of Rameshwaram temple from his father. Now he is telling what was the profession of all his friends. Ramanathan Shastri was son of Rameshwaram temple head priest. Later on he became the priest of that temple. Arvindan went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrimage. Arvindan became the transporter in visiting pilgrimage. And Shiv Prakashan became a catering contractor for the Southern Railways. And Shiv Prakashan also worked for Southern Railways. He was doing the catering work. During the annual Shri Sita Ram Kalyanam ceremony, Sita Ram Kalyanam meaning Sita Ram marriage ceremony, our family used to arrange boats with a special platform for carrying idols of the Lord from the temple to the marriage site. See, in the picture you can see that for the marriage site, Sita Ram marriage ceremony they were celebrating. So his people were arranging boats. Here also you can see the example of brotherhood. There were no discriminations between caste, culture, Hindu, Muslim. This thing was not there prevailing in that society. Situated in the middle of the pond called Ram Tirtha, which was near our house. It was near their house, Ram Tirtha. There they were bringing the idols. events from the Ramayana, from the life of the prophet, were the bedtime stories my mother and grandmother would tell the children in our family. His grandmother and his mother were grandmother and his parents were sharing the stories of Ramayana as well as the prophet stories for bedtime stories. Meaning, from society, from parent side, there were no discrimination because of the caste culture, because of their religion. So he was told stories from Ramayana also, the morals. One day when I was in the 5th standard at the Rameshwaram Elementary School, elementary meaning primary school, a new teacher came to our class. I used to wear a cap which marked me as a Muslim, and I always sat in front row next to Ramananda Shastri, who wore sacred thread. Sacred meaning pious thread, that is commonly known as janeu. Because he was a Muslim, so he was wearing a peculiar cap which was making him Muslim sort easily, and he was sitting with Ramananda Shastri, and Ramananda Shastri's chest there used to be janeu. So the new teacher saw it first time. The new teacher could not stomach a Hindu priest's son sitting with a Muslim boy. For the new teacher, it was difficult to digest that a Muslim boy was sitting with a Hindu boy. In accordance with our social ranking, as the new teacher saw it, I was asked to go and sit on the back bench. So the new teacher, what he asked me, he told me to go and sit on the last seat because I should not sit with a Hindu boy, according to the teacher. I felt very sad, and so did Ramananda Shastri. I felt very bad. The same bad thing was felt by his friend Ramananda Shastri also. He looked utterly, meaning completely downcast, as I shifted to my seat in the last row. When I shifted in the seat of last row, so I felt very bad, and he also was also feeling very downcast. The image of him weeping when I shifted to the last row left a lasting impression on me. The image when I was going, the way he was crying, he was weeping, so that image kept remain in my heart for long, and this made a deep impression image on my heart. After school, we went home and told our respective parents about the incident. So about that incident, both of the boys told to their parents that because of Hindu Muslim, they were not allowed to sit together. Lakshmana Shastri summoned the teacher, summoned meaning called, and in our presence told the teacher that he should not spread the poison of social inequality and communal intolerance in the minds of innocent children. And Lakshman Shastri, the head priest of Rameshwaram temple, he told in front of us to the teacher that he should not spread the poison of religious discriminations, and the innocent mind of children should not be corrupted with such information. He bluntly asked the teacher to either apologize or quit the school and the island. Lakshman Shastri quickly said whether you should say sorry to the children or leave the school, leave that island even. Not only did the teacher regret his behavior, but the strong sense of conviction Lakshman Shastri conveyed ultimately reformed this young teacher. See, the teacher not only felt sorry, but that casteism difference was also corrected in the mind of the